Facing what it calls an immediate budget shortfall, the Navy announces a number of cutbacks. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. Those cutbacks could significantly impact all four shipyards all across the country, including the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard in Kittery. Live at 6, News 8 Steve Minich is across the river in Portsmouth with the latest. Steve?
Well, Tracy, this four-page memo from the Navy's Chief of Operations outlines what needs to happen until lawmakers in Washington pass a new defense budget. Right now, the Navy is operating under the same funding from last year's budget, which it says just does not provide enough money. In the meantime, workers across the river at the shipyard are keeping a very close eye on this situation.
It's been made very clear to me that nothing is off the table.
Paul O'Connor heads the metal trade union, one of some 4,700 civilian workers the shipyard employs. Among the Navy's announced budget cuts, an immediate hiring freeze on any more civilian workers, and postponing a number of shipyard projects, including the remaining repair work on the nuclear submarine USS Miami, damaged last year by fire.
It's impacting our strategic planning. It's impacting our ability to plan for training, for materials. It doesn't work to not know what the budget is.
And as of right now, there's no indication as to when Congress may address the budget. In calling for Senate leadership to act soon to avoid any automatic cuts, Maine U.S. Senator Susan Collins said in part, "While I am deeply concerned about our nation's rising debt and believe Congress must look for balance and responsible ways to reduce federal spending, I oppose the indiscriminate, automatic, across-the-board cuts to defense spending. Such meat axe cuts would negatively affect jobs around the country."
Congress could have an epiphany and figure it out. We could be devastated by budget cuts that you can't possibly plan for.
The Navy memo also states, if the budget situation continues to go unresolved, civilian workers face possible mandatory furlough days, as many as 22. O'Connor says that's one of his greatest fears.
We're like everybody else. Most of us are living paycheck to paycheck.
Now, we did contact the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard asking for a comment, but no one returned our calls. Live in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, Steve Minich, News 8.